In solar installations, everything is getting bigger. The size of the panels, the power levels, operating current, and size of installations. Why? Because solar panels are getting cheaper. However, with everything getting bigger, so are the chances of making a big mistake. So that's when a handy tester like this becomes so useful. It's just helped us to discover that the team missed out connecting two of the panels when connecting the strings. Hardly surprising in a dash to get out of the rain. Now, normally in our videos, I'll run through the features and we arrive at the point when we need to mention the price and perhaps a look in the description. As with all test gear, it could be considered reassuringly expensive. But to put that into perspective, the most expensive thing on this roof is the way of getting up here. Yes, the scaffolding is more expensive than the panels, which shocked us, as the yard it comes from is just a few meters away. So to put it another way, if we dropped this scaffold, then discovered a mistake, by the time we'd put the scaffold back up, we'd be halfway to paying for the tester. So it appears scaffolders are making all of the money in solar. They could even be the people trampling over the panels, causing micro cracks, so you need to put the scaffolding back up. If you're a regular eFix viewer, this tester may seem familiar, as we featured the previous version on the channel last year. But like the development of the solar market, this one has been updated to reflect the needs of these bigger installations. So what has changed with the unit? The current input from the solar strings can now accommodate up to 40 amps with string voltages rated up to 1500 volts DC. This means it's easier to test larger installations, particularly ones which include parallel array connections. The connections are much simpler compared to the previous model, with just four connections, plus and minus for the solar string, and the earth connections to array metalwork and the installation electrical earth. No clamp meter to attach, as the current measurements are now built into this unit. The previous model's connections for irradiance meter inputs and panel temperature have vanished, as these are now provided by a Bluetooth connection to this remote data logger, the Solar O3. A major advancement is the integration of ground fault location testing, which previously necessitated a completely separate tester. This invaluable function allows for precise identification of faulty panels or connections within a solar array. Be sure to watch our previous video, where we demonstrated how this feature works by locating a damaged solar connection. The integration of this function within the PV Checks Pro truly elevates this new version to a whole new level. Let's return to the Solar O3, which facilitates the testing of bifacial solar modules. These innovative modules generate electricity from both sides, harnessing direct sunlight on the front and reflected light on the rear. Typically installed in open areas like covered car parks, bifacial arrays are easily recognizable by their transparent glass surrounding solar cells, allowing light to penetrate and generate that reflected solar generation. Testing these modules can be more complex, as it requires measuring both the direct and reflected light. However, the Solar O3 features additional inputs for additional sensors, seamlessly integrating with the settings in the PV Check Pro to simplify the testing of bifacial arrays. Just keep in mind that you will need to purchase an additional irradiance meter, as only one is included in the kit. So we're on the roof. It's sunny, it's fantastic weather for solar testing. Rick's just over there finishing a few MC4 connectors off. We've got our PV Checks Pro. One top tip when you're testing on a roof is be careful it doesn't slide down the roof surface. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna pop it on the stand because that stops it happening. The setup we've got here, we've got our lead back to the main earthing terminal for our continuity checks between the frame of the metalwork on the panels. So you need that to do the insulation resistance test. And then we've got our plus and minus from our array. The other equipment we've got on there, we've got our irradiance sensor and temperature sensor connected through the Solar O3, and that's wirelessly connected together on Bluetooth in this particular setup. So that's it, we're ready to go. We've got our connections in there. We're going to do the IVCK test. Really easy, dive in there, enter button in there, and we can already see the values from our remote sensor. I can see the irradiance value in there in watts per meter squared. That has to be above 100. So if you're not, if it's a cloudy day, you can't do the test. Time to just go home. These are important values, because they affect the current and voltage readings we're going to get from it. I can also see on here the voltage between the rays, between the positive and negative connections, and referenced back to earth as well. So we're going to start off by doing the voltage test, but it's just a single press of the button, and this is going to go through all of the tests. So just push the go button. Incidentally, before I do that, actually, if you can't remember how to connect it, if you just push the help screen, you can just double check that you've got your connections in the right place. Now, okay, so press and hold the go button, and the measurement's off already. It's already done the short circuit and the open circuit voltage test. Now we can hear that beep in there. We're not in hospital. It's now doing the insulation test between the strings and then between the strings reference to earth. And again, it keeps beeping. We don't want that continuous beep because it could mean the patient is dead. Obviously there it's checking for things like possibly some water ingress into a badly made off MC4 connector. Rick won't be doing that. He's got the proper toolkit on there to do it. So we're nearly there with those results, bleeping away. Always a nervous time, this, isn't it? You've put all those panels down. Is it going to pass? Have we missed something? So Rick's getting nervous now. He put these panels up here. They'll go, ooh, it's taking a long time. And there we go. So it's now, it's passed those tests, and then it's just quickly done the continuity test as well. So we've got a nice, okay, that's it. That's our verification test done on this array. So we can store that result and then move on to the other arrays that we have here on the roof. But you know, I don't like being up here in the blistering heat. I might want to do that downstairs. And that's the advantage of the remote sensor here as well, because we could move downstairs with the meter, and as long as we've got our Bluetooth connection, we could carry on testing. One problem we did encounter with the Bluetooth connection to the remote sensors is that it can be unreliable, particularly in buildings like this one with sheet metal cladding, which effectively blocks the Bluetooth signal to the transmitter. The Solar 03 addresses this problem by featuring a data logging mode. This allows you to leave the sensor on the roof to record and timestamp the data. Once testing is complete, you can bring the Solar 03 back within range, allowing the test data to be updated to reflect the actual irradiance and temperature values. Now, believe it or not, our installation here is quite simple, although we have made it appear incredibly complicated during this series. But imagine you're in one of those massive solar farms where you've got thousands and thousands of solar modules, and you need to test them, because what do you want to know? You want to check that they've been installed correctly, but you also might want to make periodic checks to compare with the manufacturer's data, because a lot of these panels come with incredibly long warranties, and being able to compare back to those original promises could be useful, because in a big solar farm, when you're not getting the performance that you expect, that's obviously the return on investment won't be quite the same as what you expect as well. And that's where you step up from the PV Checks Pro to this IV600. Now, it is very similar in terms of the setup and menu and everything else. It's just got a different screen. The remote module is the same, the irradiance sensor is the same, and we've also got the same temperature sensor. The big difference is it allows you to do IV curve tracing. Now, that allows you to compare that original manufacturer's data with what you're getting in the field. So basically, you input in what the array looks like in terms of how many modules in the string, and more relevant to solar farms, how many parallel arrays you've got as well. Once that's in there, you can perform the IV curve test. But the additional level in there, it allows you to compare it year on year. So on an initial installation, but then go back after year one, after year two, after year five, however long that warranty is, and compare back to that original data, identify any panels that perhaps need some warranty attention in terms of replacement, but is the whole array performing as was promised? And of course, we have to do that in real temperature conditions. That means we need our input from our irradiance meter and the temperature sensor. But apart from that, pretty similar as a family of products. The only notable difference, you can see this will take currents up to 40 amps, which you can obviously see as an increase in power for each plus and minus connection out to our strings. There's two test leads to carry that additional current. I'm just putting in the solar panels that we've got installed up here. Now, this unit has an immense database of solar panels in, but just with the rest of the luck we've had on this job, just like the weather, the ones we're using aren't in there. So I've just gone on the website and found the data sheet for that. Now, I'm guessing I could probably hook this machine up to the interweb via a computer or something like that and download the latest database, but it's nice and sunny up here, so I'll just relax and just spend the afternoon plugging in the values into here. And the good thing about this is this display is a step up from the PV Checks Pro and in terms of the ease of use of the display. It's nice and clear. It's easy to enter. It's very well backlit. Even on an incredibly sunny Skipton day like today, I can see that. It's nice. So I'm just going to plug in this data from the data sheet and see how we get on. It's a new parameter I've never came across before. Perf year one. And I don't think that's perf with surf. I think it's something to do with the performance after year one. Something to do with it. Pensions, more your thing this, Gary. The interesting thing on this, you have to set the minimum irradiance, and its default setting is 600, and this is quite a gorgeous day for around here. A more realistic target is the absolute minimum here in Skipton, 100. Now, of course, people are going to be wondering about price. Should I be going for the PV Checks Pro, or should I be stepping up to the IV600? I'd suggest it's probably a tester for those people who are doing solar farms, because in price comparison, it's significantly more than the PV Checks Pro, as we'd call it, four scaffolding setups. But you do get this rather nifty carrying bag. Of course, solar PV installations are a game of two halves. You've got what's going on the roof on the DC side, but you've also got all that testing that needs to be done on the AC side down at the inverter. And I'd recommend you check out this video on screen now, where we feature the TIS MFT Pro and a man sliding down the stairs.